The Cambodia I knew as a child was a beautiful place. Things grew quickly there. The air was filled with fragrance. When I close my eyes, I can still see the blue skies and the flowers. I can still see the laughing faces of my friends and family. In the evenings, we would sit under a full moon and listen to the crickets and tree leaves rustling in the breeze. It was good to be a young girl growing up in Cambodia.
In a late-breaking development, we go to the scene of a shooting at 15th Street in Tasker. Police tell News 10 that two people, a Cambodian male and a Cambodian female, were shot and killed in a confrontation in a neighborhood video store earlier this evening. One of the victims was identified as Lenora Khan, a Temple University sophomore who worked as a folk dancer and musician in her family's performance troupe.
It was a small, peaceful city. The people enjoyed their life as they had done for thousands of years. One day, all this changed. Suddenly, the sound of guns and bombs were heard everywhere. Many families were torn apart. Some crossed the rivers to get away. Others were caught and killed by the enemy. This was the beginning of the war.
She comes here and she's still dying.
So my relative here and they really, really want to be in America. Adore like a heaven. And my family decided to escape from Vietnam to look for a better future. We land in Malaysia coast and we learn about American life. When we come here, terrible. We're terrible.
My feet hurts and everything, man. I was just as
When I was 8 years old, I came to this country by plane. It was a scary ride because I had never been in a plane before. I was astounded by how many cars there were and great buildings everywhere. Still, I was really happy because I had many hopes that my goals would be achieved. I would be free and independent, and there would be no more war. After I lived here a while, I could see that Cambodia and America are not so different. America has never been invaded, but many small wars are happening inside it. I'm often scared to walk in the street or go to school.
I think you're blind.
No, probably they walk like around a corner or something. We have to find a phone that works. Maybe near a store.
Like over there?
In a store.
I know, there in a store.
I ain't going over there. That's all I know.
For me to get to school, though.
Yeah, just one way to go to school.
I know.
Maybe it's only there.
Okay, let's just go. Come on.
Take a U-turn.
Monday.
Monday.
Pastor, Monday.
In a few years, I began to see racism in my school. Later, I was afraid because the other students would follow me and call me bad names and tell me to go back to my own country. If I don't, they will hurt me. As a young child, I grew up with violence and prejudice, but I did not expect to find it here.
No more than two students are allowed in the store at a time. You're going to have to leave. Call the phone company. That's really not my problem. Are you going to buy that newspaper?
Hold on.
Listen, if you're going to read it, you got to buy it. Come on now. You're going to have to go.
My mother.
Are you going to buy that paper or not? That paper's 50 cents. You want to buy it? I'm running a store here. You want to buy the paper? Buy the paper. Don't make me have to. No, you can't just see it for a minute. I'm going to have to ask you to leave now.
Hold up.
I said I'm going to have to ask you to leave. I'm not going to hold up. You have to leave. Thank you.
Hey, what were you looking at? Oh, that was the girl that got killed. She was in front of the newspaper.
She was Tom's cousin and she was going to get married.
She does in the temple.
What kind of dance?
Come
on and
dance. You know.
I would
dance. I didn't know she danced.
What are we gonna do? All the best people just leave us. We can't continue our culture.
You know, she's really talented.
She's a really good dancer.
All Cambodian people know her.
Should we all be Americanized?
I don't think. You should keep your culture. It's very important to keep the culture.
We can't keep running away. Because we're tired. We've seen a lot of death.
Is this where it happened?
That's what they say in the paper.
Many children refused to listen to their parents and ran away from home. Some joined a gang and adopted new ways. They became Americanized too quickly by being with the wrong crowd. Then many crimes began. Many innocent people were killed.
Thank you.
The 10 kids is missing. Two of them from your class and two of them from your class. Lenora, that was 2 days ago.
And now it's here, so no one called the parents yet.
No.
We should do something. We should go down there and call the parents, let them know about it.
Who are the kids?
Hank, Mr. King.
As I grew older, my parents would remind me to stay home because it's safer than anywhere else. They want me to remember my culture always and the country from which I came. I am now part of a company of dancers who perform in the traditional way. I want to show the people of my new home the beautiful parts of our culture so that they will learn and I will not forget. I feel that I am lucky. My family has made a great journey to America, and we are still together. I never thought this would happen when we were running in the forests of Cambodia and crossing the river into freedom.
And it told us about Miss Lenora's death. Then we went to the temple to pay our respect to her.
And Kenita says she saw a vision of Lenora dancing in the temple.
I never thought that I would get this far. Others were not so fortunate. Lucky for me that I lived.